Hello and welcome to episode 4 of my Beginner's Guide to Evernote 10. And this week, we're going to learn how to stack your notebooks. Now, what does stacking notebooks actually mean? Well, think about it this way. Normally in a file system, you will have a parent folder, which is normally the big parent folder. And inside that folder, you can have what we normally call child folders or subfolders, if you like, and they come inside the main parent folder. And you can do this in Evernote, and Evernote actually call it stacking, notebook stacking. And that's what I'm going to show you how to do this week, because having that structure in place, that foundational structure in place before you start adding thousands of notes is really going to help you. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you want to learn everything you can about Evernote, tips, tricks, and anything else, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my demo Evernote account now, and I'm going to show you how to create your very own stacks in Evernote 10. Okay, so going back to my demo account now, so we've got the very basic notebook structure of an inbox to collect all your notes, a personal notebook, and a work-related notebook. And last week, if you remember, or the last episode, we created our first note, which is right there. And if I click on that, that will bring out your first note. But let's go back into notebooks right here. And what we can do is we can create what's called, Evernote likes to call, stacks. Now, stacks essentially is a parent followed by child notebooks. Now, this is great because if you look here, personal could have all sorts of things in there, and so could work. And when we go further into this beginner's guide, I'm going to show you a way of organizing notebooks that is a little bit more advanced than what we have right now. But for now, I just want to keep things simple so you can follow along and really learn how to get the most out of Evernote. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new stack. Now, the best way to do this is to first to create a new notebook. So I'm going to call this family holidays. Now, I'm not going to add family holidays. I'm not going to add a number to this because I only use numbers, or I always recommend numbers to use for the parent, not for the basic folder. So I'm going to add continue here, and that's going to add that right there. Now, the thing is, I don't have any stacks set up right now, so we need to create the stack. So we're going to go down to let's go to the three dots right here where it says more actions. Click on that and go to add to stack. You're going to need to create a new stack, and I'm going to call this my personal stack. And again, I'm going to actually put the number in here. Now, this is not a notebook. This is just a stack. So I'm going to call this 01 personal. And you'll see what I mean in a moment. So we've got 01 personal right there. And what I will need to do now is I want to move this one into my stack. And you can just drag and drop. Once you've created the stack, you can drag and drop. Now, right here, you'll notice that the stack has a different icon to a notebook. But first of all, let's move this into my personal right there. And that's moved into that stack. So when I open the stack, it doesn't show the notes. So if I open up personal, it shows the note. But if I open up the stack, it just shows the notebooks. Now I'm going to create another one for work, because when we set up notebooks, we created the personal and we created work. But what I want to do is I'm going to create a new stack. So add stack. Add to stack. So we're going to create new stack. And again, I'm going to call this 02, and I'm going to call this work right there. So that's all set up. Add the stack, and that's added another stack. And that's added already because I used the notebook there. Now, the thing is, what I would recommend you do is go into here and change the name of this one now. So I'm going to call this change name, so you can rename notebook again from the actions. So I'm going to remove the number because I don't need the number there, and I'm just going to put miscellaneous. I can't spell. let's go miscellaneous, and add that. And if I spelt it wrong, I don't care. So there we go. Now I've done that there. Now, of course, if you want to put these in a specific order, you can do so simply by adding a number because it's going to do it automatically. By the way, what you'll notice now is the stacks have taken priority over the notebooks. And if you want the inbox up at the top, what you need to do is go to the actual section here, sort options, and remove group by type. When you do that, it'll put your inbox right up at the top again. So there's another way of doing it. Now, I would recommend that you actually do set up stacks because this is going to save you a lot of trouble further down the line. But you do need to create the stacks from an existing notebook. But once you've set it up, it's all set up. So I can put in all my family stuff in there and I can put all my work stuff in here. And again, what I would do here is I would actually rename this notebook. So I'm going to call this meeting notes. And that's just going to go in there. So now I've got to, you can rename the notebooks once you've set it up and you can reorganize. Now, the thing is, I would strongly recommend while you're still a beginner and you don't have a lot of notes in Evernote, is set this up now. Now, we will be changing these notebooks later, or I will be giving you an alternative way to manage your notes. But right now, what I really want you to do is just to get familiar with how to set up the structure in Evernote so that you do have a really good idea of how things work, so that when it comes to creating your own organization system, you know the basics of getting Evernote set up. So there you go. Quick episode today, but stacks are really important because it really does help you to build out some strong structure to your notes later when you start collecting a lot of notes. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.